Hi.
Yes, I had to come out of my comfort zone today and come live. So I was just on another video watching Tanya TKO interview this couple that you probably saw the story floating around social media about him praising his wife for working while and going to school full time while being 9 months pregnant, yada, 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 and also having a 5-year-old daughter. So I put that link below if you guys want to check out her video. Y'all will see what I'm speaking about. Y'all go back and forth if you like, but were y'all on that video? He was delivered. He was delivered. I'm like, why can't she see? Like, do they not teach that where she lives or something? Like, did her mom not pick up on that? Or her mom was just lucky, happy that she found somebody? I don't know. I feel like, why didn't no one tell her? Why didn't anybody tell her that her man rap name was Two Beards? Why didn't nobody tell her that was Two Beards? When he started speaking in the interview, like everybody just started saying, you know he's gay, right?
Mom, I'm
Yeah.
getting a call.
I am.
I'm getting a call. Who that is?
Hello? Yes. No, yes, that's correct. Just the red kind, the normal kind. Thank you. Bye-bye. Sorry, I had to get my order correct. So yes, he was obviously delivered. And if y'all know what delivered means, it means he was delivered through the Lord out of unto a wife instead of a husband. Because he kept bringing up the church at the end. So I just nicknamed him Deliverrrt. So the sad thing is, y'all got me looking real homely today. This is what y'all getting because I did not plan to come on live too much. But she was like, oh, I'm a strong black woman. I'm a strong woman. We're not supposed to be strong. It was just sad to see this type of thing that's still going on and how brainwashed people still are. Hey, thank you for the donation, signing. The link's below in the description. Y'all can watch that interview. So if y'all are trying to catch up, just go watch the link in the description and then come back. Okay. So anyway, I was just commenting all up and through that, and I was just like, where was he at Pride? Where was he at during Pride Week? Did you keep tabs on him during Pride Week? Because for me, it's almost like he was proud of the fact that basically with a mule. Like, let her do what she needs to do so she could take care of me because I'm the feminine one in the relationship, basically. So she was giving off more masculine vibes and he was giving off very feminine vibes. So everybody in the comment section was just going off and she was obviously ignoring those things. So for me, I'm like, the main problem is not even her working. The main problem is not even her being pregnant. The main problem is not even all of that. The main problem is she don't even know who she married to. That's number one. Number two is it seems like she's just happy to have a man. Don't even matter if he's straight. It just seemed like she happy to have something, which out. So to me, she is like in double denial. And when she figures out the truth, she gonna have three kids or more, worn out, overworked, and probably about to drop dead. And I just hope that she figures it out due to the video and the interview that Tanya did with her. And hopefully she sees this video. Now, yes, I'm married. Yes, I got kids. No, I didn't work while I was married. Or pregnant. I said, or pregnant. Look, while I was married or pregnant. Or dating. You know what I'm saying? I quit 2 weeks before I even met James. That's how bad it is over here. So, I said 2 weeks before. So, and even if I didn't get married, I would rather be single than to settle for the dusty Deliverrrt man, okay? I would rather be single than settle for dusty and Deliverrrt. Okay, the only thing I like Deliverrrt is my food to my house. And, you know, these types try to cover it up with religion and church. Do you go to church? If you say church like that, I don't go to church. Okay, when they say in church, them lit like church, you know what that means, Deliverrrt. So, no, I don't go to church. And, and you can be Deliverrrt all you want, but everyone sees through that. And I feel like that's your business. I don't care. I love all people, but don't lie to the woman that's carrying your children. Maybe she knows already. I don't know, because I've had consultations with women who will marry and date a man who is bisexual. And that is their choice. And their freedom of choice. But at the same time, do they love themselves? In order to settle for someone that could potentially bring disease and harm to them and their children? I don't think so. It's like they can't get anything else, so they settle for that. I feel like that's y'all's business, but still, whatever, more power to you. But if she knew, if she already knows, then that makes it even a worse story, because at least he should be doing most of the work if she knows that, or his boyfriend need to be helping out or something. I don't know. And she's not even ugly, y'all. I could understand if she was ugly. I could understand if she was ugly. Then I wouldn't even be on here wasting my breath. But she has so much potential. Like, she has very, very attractive face. I know she's pregnant, so I can't tell what the rest of her looking like for right now, but she don't have to be there with Deliverrrt. You know what I'm saying? She, you know what, with all that thing floating around, you know, she could start her own YouTube channel and stop working. Like, that's what I would suggest for her. And keep Deliverrrt up off of there. You would do so much better without him. Just leave him in the background and have him work while you do your social media and YouTube. Like, that's my suggestion for her. And I don't even like calling her a work mule, because she shouldn't be working. She's a lady. She needs to be treated as such. They live in the South. I live in the South. I don't care what they say about Southern women and this. There's Southern Belles and Southern Mules. Okay, which one are you? Okay. The link is in the description bar. So anyway. Yeah, I can tell she's pregnant with twins. But it doesn't look good. You know, her hair wasn't a hot mess. So she has potential. I mean, she's pregnant with twins. She looked good to be pregnant with twins to me. But the whole point is I don't want to down her. I'm downing him because he is the man. He's supposed to be protector and provider. And he need to be the man in the relationship. He need to say, look, you pregnant, sit your butt down. I'm going to take care of the bills. You just relax. What do you want to drink? What do you want to eat? Let me handle this. But he don't know how to do that because he haven't been fully delivered. So he need to go. Y'all watch the description. Watch the video in the description link if y'all don't know what I'm talking about. I can't keep re-explaining. So, right. Broken link. Go to Tanya TKO in her last video. Tanya TKO. Go to her last. Okay. That's her channel. Right. Thank you, Bianca. He grabbed my neck during a fight. Broke up with him today. We'll move out soon. How to handle a breakup. Don't want to get married. Have kids with a toxic girl. You need to call. First of all, go call the police. Okay, you broke up with him. Girl, what the heck? Thank you for the donation. But yeah, you need to leave that behind. If I were you, I'd go call the police and get him arrested and get me some Crime Victims Association money or something. Need to do something. I'm sorry. And seize every opportunity. So, yes, please don't deal with Dusty's. If you're pregnant and still working up to 9 months, you ain't got no type of man. I don't know why y'all still do this. I don't know why y'all put up with this. It's crazy. This is crazy. As soon as you're pregnant, you need to quit your job. As soon as you find out you're pregnant and you married or you got a man with some money, quit your job. Just quit. Right then and there, right before you even gain your first pound, quit. Because that's your new job, being pregnant. That's it. If you live with a grown man and he cannot fully provide for you, if you got pregnant, then you need to go not get pregnant. Okay? or he needs to save up so he can. So anyway, I thought I would just touch on this topic and let you guys know what I thought about that because that's what y'all wanted. I'm not going to be on here long. I just wanted to come on for those people that really wanted me to talk about it. I feel sorry for her. I don't feel sorry for him. He know he guilty inside, deep down. He feel bad about everything he's doing. He's like one of them pastors that be lying to the congregation. He already know where he stands. Right. And it was interesting on the video. Tanya asked the lady if she trusted him, or her husband asked, do you trust me? And she said, yeah. But a woman that trusts a man will quit her job and not have one worry and just relax. She trying to go to school and keep her job. That means she don't trust him double. That means I don't trust you because I'm about to have all these kids. I'm gonna need to support them and get an education so I can make more money in the future because I know you ain't gonna do nothing. She don't trust him as far as she can see him. Okay? She trusts him. She may trust him around other women, but she probably don't trust him around other men. And she probably knows deep down inside one day he gonna come to her and say, baby, I got something to tell you. And she already gonna have degrees in hand. Money saved, top-notch job, kids in tow, and she gonna already be prepared to be like, I already know it. Go ahead and go be with Clyde or whatever his name is. And she's going to keep it moving because she says she was strong. She may not admit it now, but she already have her backup plan because she already know deep down inside that boy don't want her. He has two beards, her and the one on his face. Okay? So she don't trust him, and I don't trust him. Okay. She might have a computer job, but she's not savvy in right. So what do you think she should do now? We know what she should have done. She need to have them kids. Give him, make sure that, I mean, there is nothing she can do except stay in her situation. I would have quit. I would have quit a long time ago. Maybe after these videos, she'll have the nerve to quit and let him be the man he claim he is. I don't know. It would seem that she would have the perfect excuse and reason to do so. I mean, I would take this opportunity and be like, you know what? They right. I'm quitting and see what happens. You such a man, then you go ahead and handle your business, or I'm getting right back online and telling these people the truth. She need to use every angle she can. I feel like she's so thankful and desperate to have some type of man in her life that she'll put up with it, but I wouldn't. Not after the videos and things that are being said about them online. I really wouldn't. Mm-hmm. And he even mentioned that there was a prior man who was the father of her 5-year-old. He even mentioned that. He told her business. The man told her business online. Like, well, the other daughter that's with her biological father, blah, blah, blah. So, yeah, you missed that part. It's close to the end. He called her out saying that she had a child with some other dude. Okay, so will the pattern continue? When Clyde get his act together, he going to be out too. You know, when Clyde finally get his benefits, he going to be out too. Anyway. He told her business to make himself look better. Exactly. And he's the one, like, who are we discussing? Just watch the link in the description box. Or go to Tanya TKO, watch her last video. So, you know, with this, we're talking about the lady that's floating around on the meme with the man talking about, ooh, my wife pregnant with twins, working full-time, going to school full-time, and still keeping the house. What you doing? What you over there with Clyde? Because the interview is below. If that link doesn't work, just watch the last video Tanya TKO put out. I'll try to relink it later. And I'm like... Girl, I'll be giving people names. I gave him a rap name, Two Beards, and his other name, Deliverrrt Dusty. We already know her name, Pick Misha, Bob the Builder, Chick, but she has potential. She can change. Mm-hmm. To just be honest with each other. And I know Clyde boyfriend somewhere steaming, wishing he could make his appearance, because you know he's probably a flamboyant one and want to be on social media and get viral. So I'm pretty sure he's going to pop out sometime soon. Anyway, this is going to turn into a whole mess. I guarantee y'all, this is not the last time y'all gonna see them. Clyde waiting in the audience to pop out. He is. Go listen to him. Go listen to him speak. But it doesn't matter. But to lie to your wife about it is what the problem is. Unless she already know and just that desperate. What grown man was rolling his eyes and popping his neck? Girl, I thought he was going to pop a piece of gum in his mouth and start patting his head. Oh, yeah. Layla, thanks. Go listen to it for the door. My name, Jingle Jingle. She will divorce him in 4 years when she is all used up and done, girl. Anyway, I'm done, child. Am I going to do... Oh, yeah, I was actually going to do a haul video on my beauty channel. And some other... I have another video that I was editing to release on my beauty channel. So I'll probably do that this evening. But thank y'all. Tiffany, thank you so much. How do I tell if my man is on the down low? Girl, if you think it, he is. If you think so, he is. You shouldn't have to question that. If you have to question a man like that, he is. Okay? Because I ain't never had no questions about it. You know, he is, if you think so. If you have to ask, he is. Exactly. There should be zero doubts. Okay? It is too many. Mm-hmm. Look, they telling y'all in the comments. Everybody is telling you in the comments. Just read those. If I have 1% doubt, that's too much for me, baby. I'm like, okay. I'll start calling girl. Hey, girl. This one lady that I did a consultation with, she said that she moved to California. She was from Texas. Because down here, we could tell easy. She moved to California and she was dating this guy. She thought he was gay because of how he acted and talked. I guess it's different in California. And she kept calling him girl because she figured, oh, he just probably needs a beard. And she just forgot that she was on a date for a second because of how he was talking to her. And she kept accidentally calling him girl and talking to him like a girl. And so he never called her back. And I'm like, well, maybe he wasn't gay, or maybe he wasn't outwardly gay, and he maybe just got offended because you called him out. I don't know. So sometimes, you know, like, people can just tell, and they just not even gonna, it's gonna be too hard for them to hide it. I asked him if he lived in Atlanta. Yes, this lawyer had the nerve to ask me to see a movie. Ha ha ha. I met a guy like that who was from San Francisco. He's very heterosexual. Ask him to play. Maybe he was embarrassed because it seemed to be obvious, right? I know I can. What? Anyway. Nothing against anybody. I'm just saying, if you're going to lie to someone and, you know, lay up with them every night and, you know, marry them and be a part of their life, they need to know the truth. Because some people will actually accept that. I know a lot of women who ask me, is it okay that I don't know if it's okay. Is it okay with you? Is it okay with your mom? Is it okay with your grandma, your daddy? I don't know. Go ask them. I'm not in your life. I'm not in your family. Thank you, Tiffany. He loves what? Okay. More power to him then. A straight man ain't pretending. Right. So anyway, I just hope they both see this, and I hope they both have this talk together. She need to ask him the real question, and if she already knows, she need to ask herself, does she love herself? Or is she just desperate? Okay, like for me, I'd rather just have my one child.
Two child.
And keep it, and keep it moving.
Children.
Okay, that's what happens when you go to the church to meet these men. Sometimes you be getting them Deliverrrt men. You know that's where they probably met, the church. Church. Don't go to church looking for a man. He's looking for a womb to rent. And he gonna be like, oh, I'm deliverrrt in the Lord. Oh, no, that's a sin. I don't believe in that. Wear my hair up here. This all my hair. I have in a bun. This is my real hair today. I ain't got no wig on. I'm all natural today. Y'all got me on my wigless day. Y'all done got me on. I didn't. Okay, so I did look bald headed, or didn't I? Look. This is what I look like if I was a man with makeup on. But here's my bun. I did look bald though, didn't I? Like I didn't realize the camera wasn't on my head. So thank you. So yeah. Stop meeting them deacons. Okay. Oh, should you withhold kissing? Of course, girl. I ain't kissing no. With herpes going around these days, I'm gonna blow people a kiss. And don't be letting people kiss all on your babies either. Oh, let me give the babies a kiss. And the baby come out with bumps everywhere. Thank you for your channel. Love you. And no, you know, like you don't know what people have. Don't be kissing on people. I did. He said I'm disrespecting him. That was it. Okay, well, I don't care what other people think. Whatever you think is right for you, then that's the standards you need to stick with. You know, if it's right for you, stick with it. Mm-hmm. Somebody said, why do black people have so many problems? Because they won't come out of slavery mentality. The man won't step up and be the man, protector, and provider in many cases, not all cases, because my husband is black. But in many cases, they won't step up and be who they're supposed to be. You know, they keep making excuses for it. They want to be the woman in the relationship. They don't know how to be the man. I don't know. That's why I think there's so many issues, because they won't evolve. They too busy playing video games and trying to get to the club. I don't know. Like, they won't grow up. A lot of these men will not grow up. They stay eternal boys.
That's why they have them do sports.
Mm-hmm. Like, Sasha, is that why they have them do sports? We all want to hear about. Anyway, so if it's the food, well, whatever it is, it's not affecting everybody. I guess only the strong survive, eh? Why do they stay boys? Because of Pick Misha and Bob the Builder, because they have options to stay boys. If you stop acknowledging them, if you stop dealing with them, they will be forced to grow up. And too many people fall for the okie doke and take on and adopt a boy band. And that's why it continues. So if y'all stopped adopting boy men, and stop using the "but I love him." They may grow up if you allow them to be men and stop trying to be their mother. Right. Thank you, beautifully, Jay. Hi, Sheer. I quit my job yesterday. I was fed up with them heifers at work. I'm still leveling up. Nowhere near done. I started an Etsy shop. I make handmade items. I haven't sold one thing yet. Anyways, thank you for the donation. You have to pay for advertising. You have to start a social media, get on Instagram, share pictures of your items, do giveaways, get followers, you know, go on Facebook or join all these groups. Start listing your stuff everywhere. Go take your link and go everywhere. Okay. You got to do the work. You got to treat your business like your job from day to evening. Okay. But good luck with your business.
Yeah.
You gotta advertise. Nobody knows where your shop is if you're not out there blowing it up, you know. Black men are the only group who expect so much from their women. That's because they're treating their women like their mother, but will abandon them in a second. So think about that one. I ain't finna do nothing extra for nobody if they can get up and abandon you in 2 seconds. You're gonna have to do for me, give you the opportunity to abandon me. So I think people's thinking is very backwards, and they're just so desperate. It's like you can smell the desperation on somebody. Like, look. For me, I would rather be single than be with someone that I cannot depend on. Or the kids can depend on. Sure, I dumped my Dusty yesterday. Good. Level up is on. Right. Good for you. How about you work to please your woman? What? Right. You know, I made a video and I said, you have one job. One job. A man has one job. And they complaining about the one job they got. Provide. They got, you know, you barely have to protect now because we got guns and knives and, you know, military and stuff and law enforcement. All you got to do is provide. Just one job, uno, and asking for help with one job when women have hundreds of jobs, right? So I'm like, you know what? You got one job. What's the problem? But they have too many people babying them, coddling them, trying to help finish raising them, trying to heal them. Look, ain't nothing wrong with them. Ain't nothing wrong with them. They just need to do their one job and that's it. Mm-hmm. Bye, Sasha. Go check and see if they're here. But close the door. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Sure, I'm in a relationship with an old rich man. How I talk about how to live together in the ring. Girl, just get the ring. Tell him no this without that. No this without ring, baby. No, unless I get the ring. Right. I've seen it countless of times. When do we get babied? Huh? When do we get babied? Yeah, I don't know. When you a baby? Right. So I asked if I could use the points to get free food. He said I can get free food with his. Give it back. What? That sounds like Dusty talk to me. I don't understand it. I know right then and there he didn't want to provide nothing, not even free food. Girl, I wouldn't even been. You lucky you dodged that bullet. Hey, Sash. Mm-hmm. Some rich men are also cheap, such a waste. True. Close the door, baby. Yeah, I did speak about him on my video maybe the other day. I was like, I hadn't heard him speak yet. So once I heard him speak on her behalf, I was like, oh Lord, where's his boyfriend? Okay. Mm-hmm. You need to make a video called Don't Allow Stereotypes to Get You Scammed by Dusties, because some of these black women seem to think whites have money, they get end up scammed. The only time I think people have money is when they putting it in my hand. So I don't know why they're getting scammed. Okay, everybody dusty if they pay rent and have car note. Okay, well, everybody dusty if they pay rent and have a car note. Okay. Well, they not as dusty as this dude in the video in the link below. But the whole point is, people in 2019 still think it's okay to fit the stereotype of this strong work mule woman. Like, it is not okay. You're just emasculating your man and making yourself look more masculine. That's all you're doing. No one sees you as a strong woman. People just see you as someone who go pull the load. That's it. You're not even feminine to them. You're just pulling their load. For me, I need them to be concerned with every breath I take. Oh, are you okay? Do you need something to drink? Oh, put your feet up. Da, 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 da. I don't need nobody telling me when you going to work. How much is your check this week? You know, bills is due. I don't want none of them questions being put in my ear. Okay? If you got to hear that as a grown woman living with a grown man, pregnant, something's wrong. Mm-hmm. So, you shouldn't be stressed that much. You stress from work. You stress from school. You stress from this dusty dude in your ear. You stress from the other kids you already got. How much more can you take? You know, close the door, baby. How much more can you take? How much more? Like, for me, I'm not even getting up to feed the animal. They gonna have to feed them. Okay. So. And then when, you know, the guys turn right around and ask, well, what are women good for? Da, 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 da. Because they don't see the precious state that you're in while you're pregnant because you're too busy being a work mule. They don't understand how hard it is to be pregnant because you up there sweeping and mopping and working and clocking in and clocking out. So they don't see pregnancy as a miracle anymore. It's just you a farm animal. Hey, Layla. Y'all, it's Layla's birthday. Say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
What you got on your mouth? Gum? This is gum? You got stuff all over your face. Everybody says happy birthday, Layla. Yes.
Layla's not here yet.
The food is not here. Where's my phone at? That's mine. Let me check the status, darling. You know they have to make it.
Yeah, it took them like a minute to make it.
It's on its way, baby. Okay. So, right. So they don't see pregnancy and bringing a child into the world as something sacred because it's not to them. It's not sacred to them. Okay. And half the time they didn't even want the child that you're carrying. So why try to convince them? Why don't you convince them by quitting your job of how sacred this is? Oh, guess what? I'm quitting my job because I'm pregnant. There is no choice. You will provide. Or you're gonna get on this child support. Thank you, Layla. Happy birthday, baby. Go eat. Get some of your cake.
I did.
Okay. Today my son turns. Oh, that's your son's birthday too. Tell him I said happy birthday, girl. Leo's in the house. So anyway, if you're in a situation, stop being afraid. I think most women are afraid to quit their job because they know they man ain't gonna help them. They laid down with a loser and they know it. And they're afraid to quit their job because they don't trust the loser that they appointed to be the father to their children. So stop laying down with losers. Lay down with some winners. Whoever you lay down in, you need to wake up rolling the money. If you laying down with brokenness, you're going to get up with brokenness. Lay down with some money. We wouldn't even be having this discussion if most women were smart to just lay down with some money. If you're going to lay down, if you're going to marry somebody, if you're going to marry a deliverrrrt man, make sure that man is deliverrrrt with some money too. Okay? If you're going to lay down with deliverrrrt church deacon, make sure he got some money. Make sure if you're going to lay down with a dusty that he's an ex-dusty and he done got some money. Don't lay down with brokenness. Okay? That should be the message on every video. Stop sleeping with broke men. What does that say about you? Go ahead and get it. Layla's 12. She can do it. Daddy's in there. So, you know, these women are smart enough to go get a job, go to school full time, support a grown man, but they're not smart enough to lay down with some money. I mean, that's just good common sense. Okay. But anyway, I'm about to go. I just wanted to touch on this subject. If you don't learn anything from my videos, learn this. Stop laying down with broke men. Start laying down with some money. If you want to lay down, make sure you laying on some money. At least. All right. Thank y'all for watching. I'll see y'all later. Bye.